Good evening, and thank you so much for coming to this concert. This is a really special piece, particularly for me. Michael Colgrass was an amazing individual, and he recently passed away. I was fortunate enough to be able to, a few weeks ago, go to Toronto and be part of the celebration of life and music of Michael Colgrass. It was 2008 when he first came to the university, to the Hartt School, and did a composer in residence. And all I knew about him is that he wrote a piece called Winds of Nagual that changed my life when I heard it. I thought I knew what a wind ensemble was, and then I heard that piece and went, oh my goodness, I had no idea, as a very young man starting out in the profession. And it was always a dream to be able to have an ensemble that played well enough to do the piece. And in 2008, we were lucky enough to have him here. And when he got here, I realized that there was so much more to him than simply being a great composer. And we started dialoguing and we started dreaming up ideas and some things that we could do together. And that led to about 5 years of him being here for the summer for a week-long workshop in, among other things, teaching teachers how to compose, how to graphic notation. And so I was so lucky for those years to be able to spend a week every summer with this brilliant genius of a composer and person. And one of the funniest spirits that I knew. And then it was 2015 when we went to Michigan and worked with a high school band there on this graphic notation stuff that we were doing, and then went and performed at the and gave a clinic at the Midwest Convention in Chicago, which was a really big deal for both of us to be able to present that. And as a result of all of that work, my hope is in about another year or so, there's going to be a publication called The Colgrass Method, which I have been nurturing along with some great help from lots of folks, in particular some help from his son, Neil Colgrass, who is just a fantastic human being and did all of the video work for us in this great collaboration. And I am told that both Neil, his son, and Ula, his wife, Michael's wife, are both joining us via the stream tonight from Toronto. So if that is indeed the case, hello to both of you. Know that Michael's music is alive and well in this place, and we are thrilled to be able to offer you Urban Requiem. Michael wrote this piece for the very purpose of the title. It's really a requiem to urban living. Michael always lived in cities. He lived in Toronto, and he moved to Toronto because it was a livable city. And he wrote this as a requiem to that life. So interestingly, you'll see that the wind ensemble is set up in a very different way than we normally are. This is all his imagination playing out. So each one of these little stations that you see is a neighborhood. And each neighborhood starts to interact with each other all the way through the piece. So you really don't need to know more than that other than to listen to the neighborhoods sort of intermingle. So there's a highbrow neighborhood. There's a lowbrow neighborhood. There's a jazz club in the middle. You'll hear lots of, and there's a little really parody of a marching band that goes on. All sort of really bringing back the urban world. And so hope you enjoy this. And I just want to say that it has been a great treat to deal with these four soloists here in front of us. They have been extraordinary, and the piece was written as a saxophone quartet with the ensemble behind them, and they have done just extraordinary work. So it's been a great treat and pleasure, and also really special to be able to do this piece in honor of Michael. Thank you.
Thank you.